11. Going forward when the going gets tough is not just a test of how tough you are, but how strong your faith is. Get ready to watch this. I want you to see something. Ooh, back up, back up. There it is. All right. A bar of iron is worth $5. Some places more, some places less, so we're not going to, Jimmy, this price, let's just say $5. You take this, wrought into horseshoes, this bar of iron, it's worth $10.50. You've already doubled your price. If made into needles, it's worth $350. Look at how much you've increased it. From $5 to $350. If they're made into penknife blades, it's worth $3,285. Same $5 bar of iron. If it's made into springs for watches, it's now worth $250,000. Now, some of y'all will be happy being a horseshoe. Some of you happy being a needle, a penknife blade. But God wants us all to be springs for those watches. So when you're going through something shaping and the heat's on and you feel like you're melting and you're redoing and all this stuff and you feel like you just can't go on and you feel like you can barely lift your hand again. Oh, God, it hurts that bad, blah, 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 blah. He's taking that $5 piece of iron and he's making a $250,000 worth in you. See, this is what's so cool. The more that iron is manipulated, the more it is hammered, the more it is passed through the heat, the more it is beaten, the more it is pounded, the more it is polished, the greater its value. Let me just, you ain't got to raise your hand, but I will. How many's ever been manipulated? Hammered, passed through the heat, beaten, pounded, polished. Guess what? The more you feel that, the greater your value. You're thinking that you're worth less. In your eyes, you are worth less, but in God's eyes, look how powerful you are. Wow. So now, I'm getting ready to, here it is. Here we go. When we are going through something hard and wonder where God is, remember, the teacher is always quiet during the test. My teacher every now and then would tell me things like, put your feet down, put the chair down. They were sure you did it right, but you're the first one through. You better go check it again. I'm all right, teacher. And of course, I was just telling my daughter and my granddaughter today, I made straight A's in school except for on one subject.
Conduct.
C's and D's in conduct. I can never figure that out. Okay. Testing our faith. There's more principles. We get ready to close. With each test that you go through, watch this now. I hope this is sinking in. I hope this is something that can really get to you and get down, because this is something you've got to understand. And if you understand it, it'll make you quit thinking that you're being beat to death and beat down and beat beyond recognition without knowing that God is using this to build you up. Okay, watch this. With each test comes first, what's this? A threat. First, that threat is unexpected. Although it may be common to an area, it's unexpected. Can you imagine? Sacrifice your son? That's not expected. He's the one that's going to be bringing on the bloodline. Sacrifice my son? That doesn't make sense. Matter of fact, usually when the threat comes, you're unprepared. Although there's these guys that we just read about are seasoned fishermen. And they're seasoned fishermen. They know how to handle storms. They can't even get out of the storm. The same way. Look, they were fishermen. But look, here's Abraham. He is prepared. prepared to do sacrifice. He's the one that taught everybody else how to do sacrifice. But his own son? Wow. It's unexpected, and he's unprepared. Watch this, though. With each test comes a threat, but also comes a test. First, how are you going to respond to it? We're so good about pointing our fingers at everybody else. It's their problem. It's their fault. It's their fault. It's your fault. It's your fault. It's your fault. It's all about you doing something wrong. It's you. Guess what? Sometimes it isn't all about them. Sometimes God's trying to, watch this. He's trying to get you to take some responsibility yourself. Now, two people, they have a fight. Usually, both of them have something to do with it. Amen? I come home one day with a black eye. My daddy said, "What did you do, son?" I said, "It wasn't my fault." He said, "Well, take some responsibility." I said, "Okay then, daddy." He swung and I didn't move fast enough. There's a threat. Unexpected. Unprepared. But I got to take some responsibility this thing. Am I going to do what God said? Am I not? Why? You know what? Well, it don't make sense to me. But then with every test comes a testimony. Because now there was that ram in the thicket. And because that ram was in the thicket, wow. You know, I love this verse. Well, look at there. Past. Amen. 1 Peter 1:7 says, "These trials will show that your faith is genuine. It is being tested as fire tests and purifies gold, though your faith is far more precious than mere gold. So when your faith remains strong through many trials, it will bring you much praise and glory and honor on the day when Jesus is revealed to the whole world." Wow. Wow. You know, I like Jeremiah. Sister Brenda, can you come on, start coming on this way, please? Jeremiah 17:10, the New American Standard. "I, the Lord, search, examine the heart. I test the mind, even to give every man according to his ways, according to the results of his deeds." Job 23:10, New American Standard. "But he knows the way I take. When he has tried me, tested me, I shall come forth as gold." And then, of course, in this you greatly rejoice, even though for a little while necessary, you've been distressed by various trials, so that the proof of your faith will be much more precious than gold, which is perishable, even though tested by fire, will be found in the results in praise and glory and honor in the revelation of Jesus Christ. And though you have not seen him, you love him. And though you do not see him now, but believe in him, you greatly rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith to the salvation of your souls." I read a quote